An ANC centenary lecture delivered by the party's president. Midway through his speech, a small group began chanting. They made hand gestures signaling they wanted change. Security evicted them from the venue. The ANC criticized the unruliness.
This well-organized lecture by the president was disturbed by a few scoundrels. It is our view that this was a planned activity to disrupt the lecture. But of course it didn't succeed. There was commotion and there were people who were quite noisy, who didn't want the president to be heard.
Cameraman Rudy LeRoux was attacked as the small group exited the venue. He's being treated at a Cape Town hospital.
We must apologize on behalf of the ANC for what has happened, particularly to the journalist, and say that our thoughts are with him at this moment.
The lecture was attended by ANC leaders, diplomats and grassroots members. Earlier in Johannesburg today, the president addressed the metalworkers union NUMSA. He said the ANC Youth League was not an autonomous body, but an integral part of the ANC, and he called for the league to be disciplined.
It's not the Youth League which is out there, spare wheel of the ANC, no. It is an integral part of the ANC. That's why, for its discipline and everything, its constitution must be informed by the ANC constitution. Its constitution must be subordinate to the ANC constitution.
Kasatu said the current political environment was dangerous, that it reduced the space for engaging honestly.
Environment of divisions, deep divisions, environment of intolerance of different views, environment of pigeonholing of unsuspecting individuals, environment of comrades carrying knives against one another, environment sometimes of even assassinations, if you look at what have happened to comrades in KZN, in Mpumalanga, in Northwest.
A decision on the fate of the three Youth League leaders is expected soon.